Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Praise God through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For his glory is what it's all about, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. It's joy unspeakable and full of glory. Hallelujah. At the cross. At the cross. He beckons us to the cross. Hallelujah. He draws us gently to our knees. Hallelujah. Lost for words. Yes, lost in love. Sweetly broken. Hallelujah. Holy surrender. Hallelujah. Joy unspeakable. Hallelujah. I'm lost for words in the manifested presence in the throne room of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. It is a priceless gift. Hallelujah. Undeserved love, grace, grace, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Called us out of death, hallelujah. Called us into life, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I was under your wrath, hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Now through the cross, I am reconciled. Hallelujah. Glory to God at the cross. He beckons us. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're sweetly broken. Hallelujah. Holy surrender. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Give the Lord glory. Give him the praise. Hallelujah. This is a day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Don't get caught up in all the depression and all the killjoys. There's lots of killjoys. You know, the Bible says the enemy comes not but to kill, steal, and destroy. The Lord Jesus said that. John chapter 10. Then I know of all these killjoys. Don't let those killjoys on the internet try to kill your joy that you have in Christ. They've come to spy out the liberty we have in Christ, as the Apostle Paul said. Trying to put us under the law, handle not, touch not. Trying to put us under the law. For the Bible says, by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified. Hallelujah. Because I've been justified by the blood of Jesus. And whom he has justified, he will sanctify. And then whom he sanctifies, he will glorify. Hallelujah. We're set free by the cross of Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Do not let the Judaizers try to put you back in bondage. Hallelujah. Even as our blessed brother, the Apostle Paul, said to the Galatians, who has bewitched you? Hallelujah. Did you receive the Holy Spirit by the law or by grace? Hallelujah. Did you receive salvation by the deeds of the law or by grace? Hallelujah. Let no man preach another gospel to you. The Apostle Paul said also in Galatians, brothers and sisters, if we himself or the other apostles or an angel from heaven will give you a different gospel, another gospel than the one we gave you, let them be accursed. I say again, Paul said. He said it twice. If we or an angel from heaven will give you another gospel, let them be maranatha, anathema. Let them be accursed. Brothers and sisters, we are free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. For the law is carnal. Hallelujah. It is a schoolmaster that brings us to the knowledge of sin and death. Hallelujah. All things were fulfilled in Christ. Our Lord Jesus fulfilled the law. Hallelujah. We've been redeemed from the law of curse, of the curse of sin and death. Hallelujah. We've been delivered. We've been translated from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of His dear Son. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. All the people on YouTube, as I've been warning you guys since I've been on YouTube in 2011, and from all you who are also from the South like me, I've been warning y'all, and people from other parts of the country, I've been warning you guys. You know, in English, they didn't give us a plural of you. So, brothers and sisters, I've been warning you guys since I've been on YouTube since July of 2011. Those people who are going into all this sacred namer movement and going into trying to wear a yarmulke and a prayer shawl, and celebrating the Old Testament feast, it says right in the text, these are the feasts He gave to your people. When God made a covenant, He didn't give those feasts to Abraham, who was not part of Israel. His grandson was Israel. God didn't give those feasts to Noah. He didn't give those feasts to Abraham. It is through or Isaac or Jacob. He gave those feasts to Moses, under the law of Moses. And those feasts are for Israel. And they are a type and a shadow, but not the very thing. They're a shadow of greater things to come, which happened. Those greater things were fulfilled in our Lord Jesus Christ in the book of Hebrews, brothers and sisters. If you have any trouble with any Judaizers, go read the book of Hebrews and you will see that it says we have a better covenant. Hallelujah. We're not under the law of Moses. We're not required to go up to a natural city of Jerusalem 3 times a year, all the men in Israel, are to go up to Jerusalem 3 times a year for those appointed feasts for the nation of Israel, for all generations for Israel, those Mohadim. That's not for us, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah, it's not for us. All things have been fulfilled in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, celebrate that. Praise God Almighty, He's given us a better covenant. Hallelujah, we've been free. Free at last, hallelujah, by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, that as it says, and the Lord has given me the proof text, brothers and sisters. See, the difference is, brothers and sisters, I get on here preaching the word and give Bible verse after Bible verse after Bible verse, and all these people that are not pastors, who are self-appointed stooges, get on YouTube and babble out of their own flesh, not giving Bible verses to support their nonsense, and taking Old Testament Bible verses out of context. Brothers and sisters, it's all in the Word. Go look at Hebrews chapter 12. Here's your proof text that we are not required to follow those things. For what does it say? It says you have not been called to Mount Horeb, where the people, even Moses, was exceedingly fearful and trembling when he went to get the law, that even Moses was afraid to go on the mountain to receive the commandments and those appointed times and the law from God. But you have come to Mount Zion. Where is that Mount Zion? It's the Church of the Firstborn, is the name the Lord gave me for the online church that we have through this YouTube ministry. Joshua's ministry is orphanages and the feeding programs in the Philippines. But the Church of the Firstborn is the virtual church, the online ministry that the Lord gave me. And what is that? Hebrews chapter 12. We have not come unto that Mount Horeb where the law is and those appointed feasts for the nation of Israel. It says this is for all of your people, for all generations, for those people, the descendants of Jacob, aka Israel, given to Moses, the law of Moses, which I just quoted from Galatians to you, is a schoolmaster to bring us to the knowledge of sin and death. Hebrews says, that which is waxing old is fading away. It says the law is fading away. It's been done away with. It's fulfilled in Christ, brothers and sisters. Go read your Bible. It is in Hebrews. I'm just quoting to you right now what I just said. This is in your Bible. You want to start throwing out New Testament books? That's cult time. Go join a cult. This is not a cult. This is not a cult of Gentiles who want to be Jews. God said He gave the grace and to the Gentiles that we might provoke Israel to jealousy. Many of you are being provoked to jealousy from Israel. Israel has broken fellowship with God when it rejected the Messiah that He gave until the time of the tribulation, where the Lord will break them and bring them to their knees, and they will humble themselves and receive Yeshua as the Messiah after they've been put through the 7-year tribulation period, which is called in the Bible the time of Jacob's trouble. Jacob is also the same person who became Israel. The whole purpose of the tribulation is to deal with Israel's rejection of their Messiah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. We born-again Christians have received the Messiah. We have received the good gift that God has given us. And in that text, as I'm talking about, Hebrews chapter 12, we have not come to that, to the law, to the mountain where the law was given, where the people feared and trembled, and they had to operate in the flesh and do not kill, do not steal, all those things in the flesh. What did the Lord Jesus Christ tell us, brothers and sisters? What did He tell us? Don't listen to all these Judaizers and false prophets on YouTube trying to yoke us under the law, because it says by the anointing the yoke will be broken. Isaiah 10:17, the yoke has been broken. We're not under the law, brothers and sisters. We've been set free by the blood of Yeshua. Now what does it say? It says we've come to the mountain of Zion, the church of the firstborn, to the family of God, and those saints that's gone on before us, even the Lord Himself, the Father, is there. Hallelujah, to heavenly Jerusalem, not the earthly Jerusalem. The earthly Jerusalem is a shadow of the new Jerusalem, our heavenly home. Even as God told Moses when he was up on that same mountain, He said, make the tabernacle and the Ark of the Covenant after the pattern I've showed you in heaven. Hallelujah. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Those things that they did on earth, brothers and sisters, under that law is a shadow of what's going on in heaven. All a shadow of Christ. As Jesus said, you read the Bible, you in the Bible, Jesus told those Judaizers, He told those Pharisees, He said, you think in the law you have eternal life, but you don't. Those things that you read are talking about me. Without me, Jesus said. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. Hallelujah. No one can see the Father. No one has seen the Father anytime, Jesus said, save the Son. And those whom the Son will reveal Him. No one can see the Father save through the Son. No one can know the Father except the Son. No one can know the Son if they don't know the Father. Hallelujah. These are the things that Jesus said. Hallelujah. God sent an angel. The law was given through an angel. Hallelujah. Not through God Himself. Hallelujah. But God Himself, Yeshua, gave us the new covenant. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. You know, I've been tough on dealing with these people. But it's time for the Maccabee. The Maccabee of God to deal with these people. And by the grace of God, you know, brothers and sisters, when I got back to the Philippines now, the Lord just gave me a new mantle when I got here the first day. And I have to make a video about that, the testimony. The Lord dropped a new mantle on me. And that mantle is a Maccabee. A Maccabee. And if you know what is the intertestament period, there's the Maccabees. And the Maccabee is a hammer. Hebrew for hammer. And I'm on here as God is, you know, rekindled and revived the YouTube ministry that He gave me for Church of the Firstborn. And that's to be a hammer against Judaizers and a hammer against greasy gracers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the time is short and the day is at hand. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Even draws nigh, even at the door. Hallelujah. For the redemption, to wit, the redemption of the saints of the Most High God. Hallelujah. That is the church, the true church, the born-again believers in Christ. Now, YouTube, brothers and sisters, is full of false prophets, people that are not ordained ministers of the gospel, who are not trained in theology, brothers and sisters. 99% of the people on there is nonsense. And I have been bending over backwards with patience to entertain people who are confused by these false prophets. But no more, brothers and sisters, no more. No more, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the mantle of God. Hallelujah. And the Lord said, people are deceived. Hallelujah. From lack of knowledge. Hallelujah. People perish. My people perish for lack of knowledge. You're being deceived into self-righteousness. All of you who want to follow the law. All of you who want to wear a prayer shawl, wear a yarmulke. All you Gentiles. Even women. There's women who are wearing prayer shawls. For one thing, it's for men, and it's for Israelite men who are not born again. For those who have not completed their salvation in Christ. Wearing prayer shawls, wearing yarmulkes. All these things. And all other these, practicing these Old Testament traditions. That are a shadow, all fulfilled in one person. That's the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You don't need any of those things. Jesus is your covering. You don't, and all these churches too. That's a whole other thing. All these churches is talking about, oh, you need a covering. We're your covering. No. Jesus Christ is your covering. You don't need a tallit stick. You don't need a yarmulke. Jesus. The blood of Jesus is my tallit. The blood of Jesus is my yarmulke. The blood of Jesus is the wings that has healing in them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Yeshua. Any question you have about the Bible, there's one answer. Jesus, hallelujah, has answered every question, every problem, every situation, every denomination, every deception. There's one answer. That's Jesus. Hallelujah. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Not a way of truth or life, but the truth and the way and the life. Hallelujah. He is the mighty God. Hallelujah. He's the Lord of Sabaoth. Hallelujah. The Lord of warfare. The Lord of victory. The Lord of righteousness. The King of glory. Hallelujah. That's Him. Hallelujah. My Lord and my God, as Doubting Thomas proclaimed when he met the Lord and said, and the Lord said, put your finger in the wound in my side. Put your finger in the wound in my hand and doubt not. And Jesus also said to Thomas, when Thomas said, my Lord and my God, Jesus said, blessed are those who have not seen and believed. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. We're free. We are free. We are free. I will no longer have fellowship with people who are under the law. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Unless, of course, they're a Jewish person. And I'm trying to evangelize them. I will no longer have fellowship with people who are under, trying to be under the law when we've been set free in Christ. Just like the Galatians. Who has bewitched you? You are trying to operate in self-righteousness. All of you people who are trying to practice the law. Hallelujah. You are confused and you do not know how to rightly divide the word. The whole entire New Testament, starting in the book of Acts, all the way through all the letters, is dealing with people who are trying to steal, kill, and destroy the gospel of grace. Hallelujah. That we've been set free in Christ Jesus. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. Still jet lagged here. We've been having power outages of at least 5 hours a day, brothers and sisters. So, and of course, the internet's real slow. I've been able to get hardly anything done. You know, I've been trying to get things rolling here with the orphanages and all that, brothers and sisters. But the Spirit of the Lord is on me about this, brothers and sisters. It's just such nonsense. And what I'm shocked by, I'm just going to be straight up honest with you. I'm shocked with so many people who are being so deceived. It's because you've never read your Bible. Stop trying to read yourself into the prophets. Stop trying to figure out what's going to happen. You know, in the tribulation period, go read the New Testament and focus on the letters, the epistles, and the gospels. Stop trying to interpret Revelation. You know, there are people who are high theologians. You need to, I've said this before, you need to know and understand how to rightly divide the entire Bible before you start reading Revelation. A reason why lots of people are on the internet and not in a church is because they cannot submit to God's authority in the church. Now that's what I run into on the internet. I want to say this, as I said many times, because I always get people see my videos that haven't seen them before. You've got the Catholic Church as an example. Extreme practice of the Nicolaitans, victory over the laity. Where they somehow think they control the gates of heaven. That's why, you know, you hear about St. Peter, you know, and all this with the pearly gates. With their misinterpretation of that text. They believe that the Pope has authority over who can enter heaven and who cannot. You can only enter heaven through the sacraments of the church, being in a state of grace. And then you have the people on YouTube, most of the people who are making videos, 90% of the people making videos on YouTube are not pastors. Now, people who are making videos and giving their testimony and discussing, you know, things, there's nothing wrong with that, brothers and sisters, but there are many people on YouTube who are trying to spout doctrine. And the doctrine they're spouting is wrong. And it's nothing new under the sun, as King Solomon told us in Ecclesiastes. There is nothing new under the sun. These doctrines that people are coming up with, that they like the serpent seed and all that, that stuff's been taught for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. They're not some special prophet who got a new revelation for God. If you would go, as a matter of fact, I'll tell you what, if you want to go look at the different heresies that's been in the church since the church began, there are heresy groups that's been going all the way back to, when we read what John was writing, the first John, second John, and third John, you'll see that there was already heresies in the church. That's why John said, if they were of us, they would not have went out from among us. But since they were not of us, they went out from among us. There are already false doctrines going out like crazy, already within 50, 60 years of the crucifixion of Christ. Big time. Big league. You know, the Gnostics and all that kind of stuff. So all the doctrines that people think they got some revelation on YouTube, those are old there's old doctrines, and they've already been debated and discussed and prayed about for hundreds of years by real theologians. That's why many of you, I advise you, of course, you know, you need to listen to preachers. Like if you're watching me, of course. You know, I'm an ordained minister. And my doctrine is basically lines up with the Assemblies of God. You can go look at their 16 cardinal doctrines. I agree with their 16 cardinal doctrines of the faith. Brothers and sisters, you have to be rooted and grounded in the Word. Ephesians 4:11, for all of you anarchists, self-appointed, self-righteous, Judaizers and greasy gracers on YouTube. Ephesians 4:11, for he gave some apostles and some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, till we all come together into one body, one mature man, hallelujah, in Christ. God anoints, calls, and gives authority to his servants in the church. You need to listen to them. And there are many denominations that are not preaching the gospel. We know that. But YouTube, brothers and sisters, God bless you. There's so much false doctrine on the internet. Don't believe it. Don't buy into it. If you have any questions, you know, I spend lots of time with people giving me, asking me theological questions. I'm here for you. If you're concerned, email me, message me about some wacky doctrine you saw on YouTube. You contact me. None of these people are special prophets of God. They're not some, when people start talking about that, you know, they use themselves as an authority. Almost all these people, I've talked to them, even though I don't call them out, I've private messaged with these guys, they always say the same thing. I am, you know, the special prophet of God. They use their own self as an authority over the Bible. Brothers and sisters, there's only one authority on this earth that we have, ultimately, is the Word of God. The Word of God, any prophetic word has to line up with the Word of God. That's why, like myself, brothers and sisters, I don't know everything, but I have a degree in theology. And so when I get a word from the Lord, I already know the Bible, and anybody can study the Bible thoroughly. If you study your New Testament and understand it's not that hard. Read the whole New Testament in context and get a great understanding of the gospel. And then if you get a word from the Lord, or someone tries to give you a word, if it doesn't line up with the gospel, well, it's not from God. As a matter of fact, what does the Bible say? The Bible tells us how to operate. What does it say? It says in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 through 14, when he's talking about people giving words, it says, you know, let no more than two or three people give a prophecy, giving a word to the church, and let the elders judge those words if they be from God or not. See, so there's supposed to be, there are people who are commissioned by God and ordained by God and anointed by God to be elders in the church. They are supposed to let you know whether, hey, this word's from God or not to the church. God's got fail safes in the church. But people, because most people who are on the internet, they don't want to submit to the authority of God. And so they're running around to and fro with people who are not elders in the church, who are not appointed by God as elders in the church. And then that's where all these doctrines are coming from. Then you've got all these denominations, as I mentioned, like Catholic or all this Lutherans or whoever they are, these fallen away, lukewarm denominations that deny the authority of the Word of God, the inerrancy of the Word of God. They deny, you know, the omnisciousness of God, that they deny the virgin birth, all these things, and some of these old Protestant denominations, mainline Protestant denominations. Those are also self-appointed false prophets, of course. I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, as long as the church is on this earth, God, until the Lord returns, He will always have true witnesses on this earth, true prophets, true pastors, true elders. Even in the tribulation, of course, you have the 144,000 witnesses, and then plus the two witnesses there at the Temple Mount during the first half of the tribulation. And in this age, the Lord has some apostles, some prophets, some pastors, some teachers, some evangelists for the perfecting of the saints. He will not leave His church without some elders, under shepherds. They're out there. They're out there, brothers and sisters. By the grace of God, you know, I'll be on YouTube and be able to be used by God to help you. So email me. My email is under every video I make. Email me your questions. Theological confusion. I'll be glad to help you. You know, and I love helping people. Sometimes, you know, I get those people who are self-appointed. You know, they never even read their Bible, and they're trying to tell me all about some deep theology stuff. I can tell in 30 seconds from reading their writing that they know what they're talking about or not. Just like if you, some of you are different professionals. Suppose you're an engineer or a doctor. Say you're a medical doctor, and someone starts messaging you, trying to tell you about medicine. And you're a medical doctor or a dentist or a lawyer or whatever, and they're writing you about your profession, you'll know within 1 minute if this person is also a doctor or if they're some kind of a, you know, Walmart greeter who thinks they're a doctor because they watched a video on brain surgery. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I love you all. Just trying to get over the jet lag. I'm praying for all those who've asked me to pray for them. I'm praying for you guys. You know I love you guys, no doubt. You know, if it's not for you, hey, you know, let it slide down your back like a duck. Water on the back on a duck, as they say. My address in the States is still good. I have a very few Christian relatives. I have a Christian relative who's still receiving my mail for Joshua's ministry there at the same address that's in the Facebook group and under my videos and on the joshuasministry.com website. And I still have plenty of books. If you want to get a book, I found a few oils right before I left. I had a few oils that were, while I was packing my stuff, I found in the bottom of some of my tubs there. So I have a few vials of oil, and they can be sent, you can get it sent out to you. Just go to the website for that, brothers and sisters. PatrickWinfrey.com for the book or oil. Anyway, brothers and sisters, internet's so slow. I'll try to load up this video probably early in the morning, like 5 o'clock in the morning. Monday morning here, Sunday afternoon there. I can get it loaded up. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I came on here just to really tell you. What I got on here to tell you was that it's all joy. What I was getting at, the Lord gave me the message today that I'm doing right now. When I got out here in the place where I live, walking around and seeing the people getting ready for the Christmas season and seeing the people, children having fun and playing, and then I thought about all the clowns on YouTube, self-righteous, wannabe Jewish people who are not, who are Gentiles, who think that, claiming they got a little bit of Jewish blood and start wearing a yarmulke. instead of taking the opportunity to celebrate the virgin birth of Christ and promoting the gospel that our Lord Jesus Christ was born of a virgin, and the whole world knows that Jesus was born of a virgin because of the arbitrary day that was picked, December 25th. It was not the day Jesus was born. The Bible does not tell us what day he was born because it's not important information. But the whole world knows of the virgin birth of Christ because of that holiday that was set up. I don't care who set it up. The whole world knows of the virgin birth of Christ because of December 25th. And instead of enjoying and celebrating the virgin birth of Christ, all these self-righteous wannabe law keepers are trying to celebrate Hanukkah and all this other stuff. You know, and I've made video after video, you know, on the Feast of Hanukkah, which is not in the Mohadim, it's not in the Old Testament, but Jesus celebrated it. And Jesus went into the temple on the Feast of Dedication, is what it's called in the Gospels. That's Hanukkah, as a result of the work of the hammer, Maccabee. He went there and he stood there and he said, I am the light of the world. Hallelujah. He stood in front of the temple another time. They've got that showbread in there the priests make. They put that showbread in the holy place. Jesus stood there and said, I am the bread of life. Actually, he said it in John chapter 6. He was by the Sea of Galilee when he said it. You know, Lord, just reminded me. But he was talking about that. He is the bread of life. As he talked about the manna, you know, that bread, that showbread represents the manna. You know, give us this day our daily bread. Jesus is the bread of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. He stood in the temple. He did stand in the temple area and say, destroy this temple. Talking about himself. And I'll raise it up again in 3 days. So the Lord is fulfilling all of those things. All those things point to one person. Our Lord and Savior, the Son of Man, the Son of God, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Christ, the Messiah, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the fairest of 10,000, the Balm of Gilead, the Lily of the Valley. Hallelujah. That's Him, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Hallelujah. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the light of the world. Hallelujah. The great I Am. Hallelujah. The Good Shepherd. Hallelujah. The firstborn among many brethren. Hallelujah. The Redeemer of mankind. Hallelujah. Our Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. I want to pray for you guys. I want to pray for you guys right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, I just pray for my brothers and sisters, Father. I pray, Lord God, that they will accept the fact that it's by grace, through faith, they are saved. That it's not by the deeds of the law or by their works, Lord God. Hallelujah. They're totally, and me included, Lord, we are totally undeserving. That's what grace means, undeserved favor, unmerited favor. Father, we are wretched, blind and naked without you, Lord God. It's only by your grace. Hallelujah, Father. We receive the new covenant, not the old covenant, but the new covenant. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus, the cross of Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ. We receive Him into our hearts. We say, Lord Jesus, come into our hearts, enter our lives, and forgive us of our sins. Save us, Lord God. Hallelujah. Into Thy hands we commit our spirits, Lord God. And Father, just take us over. Hallelujah. Take us over, Lord God. Take us over, Lord. Rule and reign in our hearts and minds, Lord. Lord, that we commit to read your word. Lord, we commit to praying, Lord. We commit to worshiping you, Lord God. Help us, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy on us, Lord, in our ignorance. Have mercy on us, Lord, in our flesh. Have mercy on us, Lord, in our shortcomings, Lord God. Father, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. For your word says we can do all things through you, Lord Jesus, who strengthens us. And Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Lord, I just speak your blessings upon your people, of health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love right now, Lord God. Speak your peace upon them, Lord God. Lord, I ask you, Lord, to give them clear minds. Lord, break the yokes of false doctrine, mental illness, deception off of all of your people, Lord. In Jesus' name, for your word says those whom the Son, you said, Lord, Jesus, you said those whom the Son sets free are free indeed. Hallelujah, Father. We receive that right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you guys. Got to try to get this whole long video loaded up. God bless you all. Thank you for your prayers. Got lots of things going on here. I ask you guys to pray about that. Lots of financial needs of getting everything going. We got more orphans coming in. The orphanage number 4 and number 1. And we need to have another motorcycle with a sidecar for orphanage. We need to get one for orphanage number 4. And all kinds of those things. You know, every orphan needs a starter kit. You know, clothes, toothbrush, all those kind of things. Get enrolled in school. You know, brothers and sisters, how that might go. So, and I already know, of course, God provides. I'm just asking you guys to pray about it. Come in agreement with me about it, brothers and sisters. God, we know God will provide all that we need. He's been doing it. He is Jehovah Jireh. Hallelujah. He is our provider. Praise God. Praise God.